But suddenly your ruthless enemies will be crushed like the finest of dust.
Now that's going into the elect. It switched places. Now our enemies coming in with an onslaught, as the Lord is going to be an enemy to the majority of our nation, going to be a forever purge.
Yep.
We're going to be like at the end of the movie, Issachar, Gad, and Raccoon, man. Like, and we made it, man. But that's going to be only for a small number. The rest of you people going to be hell, man. Because it said, your children shall not see hell. The heathen shall envy thee, but shall be able to do nothing. Go ahead, up.
Like chaff, your many attackers will be driven away like chaff before the wind.
Woo! Going into those missiles hitting. Because our enemies are going to behold us going up. Didn't it say that? That your enemies shall behold you. And they're going to be like chaff before the wind, blown away by the missiles. Go ahead.
Suddenly, in an instant, I, Yahweh of heaven's armies,
in an instant, man,
will act for you. Man.
Woo! And that goes into the Lord as birds flying is going to defend Jerusalem. And by defending it, he's going to deliver it from the destruction. Because at the same time, the Lord going to rescue his elect. And it said it's going to overshadow as a mother bird protecting her hatchlings, man, from the evil, man.
Hey, this is a true love story, man. When you just break it down for the elect, this is like a novel that you can't even, like, a romance that can't even be written on paper, man.
Now, every love story, you got the hero on the white horse,
right,
getting the damsel in distress.
Yeah,
the elect,
yeah,
the damsel.
Hey, brothers, we're Cinderella's brothers.
Yeah, man. The Lord said he's going to act for us, man. That's, man, I feel good. I feel all soft inside.
Go ahead,
you know, I like you, bro. I, Yahweh of heaven's armies, will act for you with thunder and earthquake and great noise.
Now, the Lord is doing that right now as we speak to let us know that he's in this earth, that he's doing what he said he was going to do. He's going to show his presence in the earth through storms and tempests and devouring fire. Now that true devouring fire is going to come by way of the missiles, for our God is a consuming fire.
With whirlwind and storm, a consuming fire.
You see that right now? So the elect is praising the Lord's holy name right now. We ain't cowering. Lord, please. No, he's like, bring it on, bring more. Go ahead.
All the nations fighting against Jerusalem will vanish like a dream.
Woo! Now get that in Zechariah. All that fought against Jerusalem is going to be their plague. Go ahead.
Those who are attacking her walls will vanish like a vision in the night.
Woo! And can a brother quickly get Job 34:20 real quick? Keep reading.
Man, this is cold. A hungry person dreams of eating, and but wakes up still hungry.
Now these damn people, they gonna be in this hell, and you might be able to get some sleep and shit, or you might be like the people on that movie, awake and shit. Your ass ain't gonna be able to go to sleep. But if you do get sleep, you're gonna wake up thinking everything's cool. It's just a nightmare, it's a dream, and you're gonna wake up and it's more hell. It's the reality. Like the brother Zion said, you can ignore reality, but you cannot ignore the consequences of ignoring reality.
Yeah, right.
Your ass is gonna be hungry. Your child crying, you're going to go to sleep. The child went to sleep, just hungry. The pain's put him to sleep. You're going to wake up, everything cool. Shit, I got food in the refrigerator. Wake up. Just still no food. Like, damn, we still in this fucking basement and shit with no food.
Got a baby, though.
Bro, the baby's dead today and
shit,
man.
Damn. This is Job 34:20. In a moment shall they die.
Woo!
And the people shall be troubled at midnight and pass away.
Going into the missiles, man. Midnight going into doomsday clock.
Yeah.
They talk about when it hits 12,
yeah,
that means nuclear holocaust. Nuclear war has been declared. And the end of this place is not going to be good. If you're an elect member, woo, you're going to see with your own eyes the reward of the wicked. And they said the earth is going to be burned and few men left. You know, it's few men.
Hey, but what is the doomsday clock? It was like a minute and a half to midnight or something,
yeah,
like that.
Like one.
Bro, you know how close that.
Yeah, they lying. It's close.
It's closer than that.
It's password.
It's on the Lord's time.
It says, and the mighty shall be taken away without hand.
Man, going into when the Lord arrives, 2 Ezra 13, the armies of the world, it said innumerable multitude was to be perceived. Nothing at the end of it was dust and smell of smoke. It was crying, man. A whoa, just screaming. And then silence after that, man.
Hold on, I can read that real fast.
Go ahead.
This is 2 Ezra 13. And you want me to get straight to that point?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, verse 9, it says, "And lo, as he saw the violence of the multitude that came, he neither lift up his hand, nor held sword, nor any instrument of war, but only I saw that he sent out of his mouth as it had been a blast of fire."
Now, the mouth is talking about is the epicenter of the chariot, the fathership, because it tells you in Revelation, the Lord is going to come wage war on this earth righteously. And it said that the armies of heaven followed him upon white horses, pure power. Those chariots, the Lord is going to be mounted on the largest one. And it said out of his mouth, both the sharp sword. What is the sword used for? A killing instrument. It's the instrument of war. It said out of his mouth, that epicenter is going to go destruction, man.
That was going to be in that fathership.
Yeah. Cars. Yeah.
Hey, in Isaiah 66, it says, "The Lord by fire and by his sword is the Lord going to plead with all flesh." Well, this is the fiery sword we're reading about, that laser beam.
That's right.
It says, "And out of his lips, a flaming breath."
Same place. It's poetically. Because niggas want to speak to the Lord, it's like at the bottom of the mountain. But once the Lord starts talking, Moses, you talk.
That's right.
And the Lord is talking to you just like that through his men. Niggas don't want to hear. So when the Lord does talk to you, he say he's going to destroy and devour at once. That's it.
And out of his tongue, he casts out sparks and tempests.
Laser.
Yeah.
This is concentrated fire.
That's right.
You're all mixed together. You know?
It says
well,
in there.
Thought Esau was creative enough to come up with that himself?
Nah.
But he pulled that straight from the scriptures, man. That Independence Day and Star Trek laser weapons, that's straight from the scriptures, man. Esau is not that creative.
Nope. Man, super weapon. No, that's all good.
It says, "And they were all mixed together. The blast of fire, the flaming breath, and the great tempest."
Hey, the flaming breath is that laser. That's the heat. And what did it mention before that?
I'll read it from the top. And they were all mixed together. The blast of fire.
The blast of fire. Because we're going to send out a